7 says, but thanks be to God.
Yeah.
He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. But thanks be to God. He gives us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Thanks be to God. He gives us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Tuck away in your memory these words if you need a way to tag today's message. Gnats on a hotel window. Gnats on a hotel window.
All right.
We go back to our scripture. Paul is writing to the new church at Corinth. And he's wanting to confirm with them that victory is something we as believers need to take note of.
Yeah. Amen.
That when we have victory, when we have success, when we have achieved, when we reach the milestone or a marker in our life, it's a time to say, thanks be to God.
Yeah.
And to realize where the victory came from. All too often when we have victory, we're tempted to take credit for ourselves. Oh yeah, I studied hard. We may have family members who want to take credit. Yeah, I gave them the money to do it. I trained a long time to win the race. But Paul is reminding us as believers that our victory, the victory that we can be thankful for, comes from God.
Yeah.
But it comes through our Lord Jesus Christ. He's helping us to grasp and was speaking to this new church that this is a fundamental that you must believe in.
All right.
Now, when I read this scripture, I'm aware that there's always a meta message, you know, a subtext, a message behind the message.
Yeah.
Because Paul is saying not only should we be thankful and not only should we realize where the victory has come from, but I believe Paul is reminding us, as he was the church, that the victory is already out. That the victory has already been set up. The victory has already been assured. The victory has already been put in motion. He says he gives us the victory. And it doesn't say he thinks about setting up victory. It doesn't say that he might let victory happen. He says victory is there.
Amen.
Now I'm going to assume that all of us, when we think about our lives and when we think about our ministries and when we think about all that we're trying to accomplish, all of us want to succeed, I'm going to assume. It is unhealthy to want to fail. But today I'm going to just assume that we all want victory. We want victory over the things in life that challenge us. We want victory over those who say it can't be done or we can't do it. We want victory over the odds that may be against us, maybe because we're black, or maybe because we're poor, or maybe because we're of a certain gender. We want victory. By your amens, I'm believing that most of us believe this, but sometimes I do find myself wondering if we believe we can have victory. Jesus, when Paul wrote, thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. I'm reminded of that scripture that says we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. But you know, I wonder sometimes if we believe we can do all things. Because I think if we really believe it and that if we really live what we believe, there would be more smile, and more confidence, and more faithfulness, less doubt, to lay our hands on these candidates who are beginning a new pathway. I want us to wonder together and to really get ourselves positioned to receive this victory.
Yeah.
To get rid of any impediment or any obstacle or any distraction that might keep us from being victorious in the Lord. Last year I was in Israel. One morning I was at the elevator on the 8th floor where my room was.
Right.
And as I stood by the elevator looking out the window at the garden below, a beautiful garden filled with red roses and some orange flowers, I don't even know what they were, and there were some yellow flowers, oh, just beautiful. I noticed in the corner of the window a swarm of gnats.
Go ahead.
I watched those gnats. And each gnat was beating his or her wings against the window, trying desperately to get out into the garden and out of doors. I remember thinking to myself, what a shame that they're wasting their time beating their wings against the window when all they needed to do was turn around and fly out the open hallway and down the stairwell that was open as well to the outdoors. These gnats in a hotel window made me think of how it is in life for so many people. People who are seeking victory in their life, but for some reason just can't get there. As I thought about the gnats, I realized that this was their predicament, that they knew what they wanted. If gnats can see, they saw what I was seeing. The beauty of God's world laid out before them. But they only saw one way to get there.